Hey y'all, welcome. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make some barbecue chicken, some delicious whipped mashed potatoes, and some bacon green beans. But the best part about it is that I'm giving all this food away to the homeless and also just people I meet around the city. I always tell you guys to love somebody and share the food. So that's what I'm going to do today. So stick around to the end of the video where you're going to see all of this happen. So let's start to season the chicken. So here I have about 4 pounds of chicken drumsticks. I've already cleaned them and washed them and patted them dry. For my dry seasonings, I have some onion powder, some pepper, some garlic powder, smoked paprika, and chicken bouillon. Creole seasoning, my salt-free Cajun seasoning. I showed you guys how to make this already. And some Sazon Tropical. Of course, I'm gonna use some olive oil to help the seasoning stick. Now, you know we really got to season this chicken. I know we're putting the barbecue on it, but I really feel like you still need the spices in order to enhance the flavor. And really, this is not too much because remember, this is like 4 pounds of chicken and I'm just putting on a little bit of this tropical seasoning and the Creole seasoning, using it like salt and just 1 teaspoon of this salt-free Cajun. It's not going to overwhelm the chicken at all with this barbecue sauce. Your chicken should look well seasoned even if you're adding a sauce to it. Now I'm adding it all to this baking dish and I almost thought they all were not going to fit, but honey, you know we played a little drumstick jenga, okay, a little drumstick jigsaw, and we got all that chicken to fit in this pan. All right, now I'm gonna bake this at 425 degrees for 35 minutes. I'm doing a semi-homemade barbecue sauce today with some chili sauce, some Kraft barbecue seasoning, some balsamic vinegar, some of that W sauce, and also about 1/4 cup of brown sugar. But y'all already know I'm about to add some stuff that I didn't show y'all right now to this barbecue, so keep watching. I'm putting in about 1.5 to 2 cups of barbecue sauce because I actually want some left over, so I won't use all this barbecue on just this one set of chicken. At the end of the day, you really can kind of just eyeball and go by taste, but I'm putting in about 1/2 cup of the chili sauce and about 1/4 cup of this balsamic vinegar. The balsamic vinegar really adds a nice taste and a different taste. I'm putting in 1 tablespoon of that W sauce and I'm dropping in all the sugar. I'm gonna mix it in until it dissolves. And then I was like, needs a kick. Okay, about 1/2 teaspoon of some cayenne pepper, a little bit of garlic, right? And then for a little tang, I figured that it needed a little bit of mustard. So I'm putting in about 2 teaspoons and I'm just gonna mix it all into my sauce and just let this cook for about 5 minutes for all the flavors to come together. After 35 minutes, my chicken is done and I'm going to baste it because I don't want it to dry out. So I'm just going in there with a turkey baster, squeezing up those juices and putting it over the chicken. I'm then going to go in and I'm going to add some of the sauce to the chicken. Add as much as you like. I used about 1/2 of this sauce on the chicken and I saved the other 1/2 for a different recipe. Once I have put everything on the top side, I'm going to go in and just brush all that delicious barbecue sauce over this chicken. Guys, this smelled incredible at this point. If you could be here to smell this. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and flip this chicken over and I'm gonna add some more sauce to the backside because we want that browning, that beautiful color and that beautiful flavor over every single piece of chicken, front and the back. Once I have covered them, I'm gonna let them bake for about 10 more minutes. Now, while this is finishing up, we're gonna get started on these mashed potatoes. I have some new potatoes here. I'm probably using about 3 pounds, but I'm just estimating, and I'm gonna peel the potatoes. With these new potatoes, you actually don't have to take off the skin, but sometimes I just don't want too much of it. I will leave a little bit of it on there, and then I'm gonna dunk it in some water so it's gonna keep its color. Once they're all peeled, I'm going to chop them into 1/4 so that they can all cook evenly and quickly together. I have some salted boiling water already going and I'm just going to cook these until they are fork tender. Then I will drain them. Make sure you don't rinse them because you need the heat in order to melt that butter. This is 3 tablespoons of butter as well as some room temperature sour cream because I don't want to cool this down. And I'm putting in about 1/2 cup. I've also added in salt and pepper just to my own taste. And I actually warmed up some whole milk, about 1 cup in the microwave. Because remember, we want to keep everything warm, right? You don't want to cool down those potatoes because they're already hot. The best thing to whip some potatoes with is actually not a potato masher. It is your good old hand beater. When you beat it, it will break up all the clumps and it will be so easy to blend. I decided to go in with some garlic herb butter just because, you know, everyone likes a little fancy taste in their mashed potatoes, right? And I'm just beating them and tasting them until they are perfect. For these green beans, I add about 2 tablespoons of butter into a pot. And I'm going in with 2 cloves of fresh minced garlic and 1/2 diced onion. We're doing a little semi-homemade action here, okay? Because we're going to put in 2 pieces of chopped up bacon and then a little bit of this Tony's Creole seasoning. I actually am going to just do this to taste. No measurements on the seasoning, guys. Y'all know how this go. Some Better Than Bouillon and then a large can of green beans that I have drained. I'm gonna mix this all together and I ended up adding in just a tiny bit of water, no more than 1/4 cup, just to help everything come together well. And I seasoned it with some garlic powder and just a little of that Tony's to my own taste, and I let this heat up. It's time to pack these packs and we gonna fill it up. Okay, no skimp. Okay, 2 pieces of delicious chicken, a generous helping of these buttery, garlicky, flavor-filled mashed potatoes, and you know we are not gonna forget these bacon green beans. I could have tore up a whole plate of these bacon green beans. And no matter who you're giving a plate to, they all want it to look cute, all right? So I'm throwing on a little bit of parsley, all right, for the cuteness. I also added a fork and a napkin with all of these plates. All right, guys, so we're gonna go driving. We're gonna see if we can find some people to give this food to. You've already seen me pack it up. So let's just drive around and see who we can see.
Excuse me. Hi. Hope you're doing good. I'm a YouTuber, so I cook a lot of food and I have a lot of leftovers. So I was wondering if you would like one. It's like barbecue chicken, mashed potatoes, and bacon green beans.
Oh, I appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a great day,
you
sir.
Y'all for the ladies and house and gentlemen.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you, babe.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately,
I don't have another one with me, but if you give me a few minutes, I can make one more and come back.
Okay.
You gonna be out here?
I'll be right here.
You gonna be out here for
real? How many minutes you talking about?
Maybe like 10, because I gotta go.
Okay.
I, you gonna
That's
be out
fine.
All right, I'll ring. All right.
My name is Bernard. How you doing? You might need 2.
Well, I don't. Well, I
but
see.
You do that for me.
I see how much I have left, and I'll bring whatever I have left. I'll bring it back. Y'all can see how y'all gonna flip.
All right. Make sure you
bring
people.
I guess they really do. All right, y'all see where we're at. So guys, they want the food. They want it. They want the plates. All right, so we're gonna have to come back. I went back. We made 2 more plates. Y'all know I tried to leave some chicken for me, but that ain't happening today. That wasn't the Lord's plan today. So all the food that y'all saw being made, it's all gone now. So we're gonna go back to the same spot and we're gonna give out the last 2 plates. Some barbecue chicken, mashed potatoes, and green beans. Bacon green beans. Oh, I got 1 more.
Okay.
Oh, you're more than welcome.
Okay, thank you.
All right, have a blessed day. Put my foot in it. God bless you. So we just gave away our last plates. Got to meet some people around in the neighborhood, and so we're gonna keep doing videos like this where we give out some of the food just to encourage you guys to, you know, reach reach out to people, do something nice for people in your neighborhood, someone you know, someone you don't know. Okay, just bless other people and reach out to them, especially in these times. So I will see you next time in Camila's Kitchen. Thank you guys so much for joining me. Goodbye, guys.